is this kettle corn popping phantom? I'm getting drinking.
Oh my.
Hello?
So you're sick, huh?
That's what they tell me.
Cut the wit, Winger. Where are you, the Gap or Banana Republic?
Wow, Britta, you got me all figured out.
Well, I can tell you're not in bed.
That's right, Britta. I'm pretending to be violently ill to avoid lifting a few boxes because I'm 13.
And who is your primary care physician, Mr. Winger?
Dr. Schroeder, SCH. Do you want to see my insurance card?
Please.
Wait, are you at a hospital?
No, I'm at the Gap. You hear that? That's not a heart monitor. It's a machine telling me I'm low on khakis.
Dr. Tarpinian to radiology. Dr. Tarpinian.
Crap. I'm sorry. I just assumed...
Whatever. I don't blame you. I've lied before. It's probably karma that I'm sick. But believe me, if you had what I have, you'd rather be moving boxes.
Okay. Feel better. Sorry.
Yeah. I'll see you guys on Monday.
You are fantastic.
So are you. What are you doing after this?
Probably trying a couple of boot cuts. But after that, maybe like a blazer?
Pardon me, Professor Kligoris. Kligoris?
Either pronunciation is fine. Are you here for the Model UN?
All of your parts. Except for you, Jeffrey. You have locked into something here. And the only thing your character needs is more screen time.
Oh, hey, Jeff, did you know that when it snows, my eyes become large? And the
light that you shine can't be seen.
Tweet.
Baby!
He tweeted it! All hail Sir Eats Alone.
Shut up, Leonard. I heard about your prescription socks.
Hope you don't mind, Jeff, but I've got a new favorite show and I'm only on episode 6.
You guys got about 5 minutes left to eat.
Oh my, time flies when you're studying the science of life.
But I think time flies when you're joking around about movie titles that sound like names for poops.
So what? I'm done with you. He's done with you. The world is done with you.
Come on in.
He's a Hawthorne. This is what they do. He's faking. Okay, let's make this quick. I got 3 more polite appearances to make tonight. What? I'm one of the Fast and Furious guys.
Which one?
Oh, I don't know. I don't watch that shallow crap. I just pick a costume girls will like.
Lights. Camera. Dean.
Action.
Why go Greendale? Just because.
Cut.
Cut.
Lose the bald cap.
What?
I don't like it. It's hokey. It's fake. Take it off. No.
I beg your pardon? Actor?
I have worn this stupid thing for 12 days. I have made bald friends.
Well, that's your mistake.
Because it's a lie. It's Hollywood crap, and I won't allow it in my commercial. You're not.
Oh.
Yes, I am.
Well, then, you're wrong for the part!
Understudy!
That's it. That's reality.
Seriously,
just stop and get...
It is now clear that we have no choice but to team up and defeat City College. I also have no choice but to accept the role thrust upon me.
And what role would that be?
No time to squabble, Troy.
Yeah, I'm really proud of you. You're growing as a person.
Oh, good grief. He's not supporting gay people. They're supporting him. If Mexicans were buying his wipes, he would have ridden in on a donkey.
People earning respect with money is the American way, Jeff. Not that my father would have agreed. It took a federal injunction to get him to sell these things to the Italians.
Oh, I see.
I have this.
No, Pierce, you should take it.
Believe me, I'd love it, but... The terms of his will clearly say that whoever kills him gets to keep it.
You deserve a bigger office.
Biggest office I ever had.
I'm here to apologize, Dr. King, and beg you for a seat in biology.
I tell you what, Insink, you want to learn about life? Give up the phone.
Oh, you're asking me for a bribe?
I can't be bought, man. You feel me? See, prison was my walls.
But you put your walls up. You and your phone and your attitude and your Fruit Loops cologne. Your walls put up so tight, man, not even a blade of grass can get through. But even if it did, you wouldn't appreciate it. That's why you can't come back to my class.
What's your problem with me, man? And don't act like it's not about me specifically. Because you've been in...
Just pick up a good book and read.
Your porcelain neck in the light of the full moon. Too appetizing.
Unfortunate. For you. You see, some monsters cannot change, but others can.
What is this?
I'm a werewolf that feeds on selfish
vampires.
Grover insane. Jeff lost an arm in the fire.
You know the one thing you love? I'm gonna kill it! As long as it breathes, it controls our lives!
But would it help if I said I farted?
Annie, no. I can't let you fall on that sword because I farted.
No, I farted.
I farted.
Guys, I wasn't doing the Spartacus thing.
I farted.
No, seriously.
We all farted.
Oh, you guys.
Professor Kane has never taken a bribe from anyone in his life. You feel me?
Yeah, I lied, but you seem to have a harder time being the bad guy than me.
You're right. I do. Which, in a weird way, makes me a pretty bad guy.
We're one and the same.
Please don't.
Oh, I'm scared.
Kendra with a QU. They can kill most of us. But as long as nobody gives up, somebody will make it through. Understand?
Yes.
Charge!
Well, I'm out. We lost.
See you at Denny's?
Denny's is for winners.
I feel bad. I shouldn't put so much effort in.
It's okay. I just think this study group is my family, you know? And if we start picking and choosing...
Where do we stop? I get it. You're a good kid. And I want to do my part to help you stay that way.
What? Why?
To prove I'm a responsible dad.
This proves you're a kidnapper. What the hell's wrong with you?
I am nuts, Jeff! Get with the program!
Oh my God, what have I done? I can't believe I actually said you could be a father.
And honestly, once the shame and the fear wore off, I was just glad they thought I was pretty.
A gumdrop!
Yay, let's find Santa some more.
Exhibit C, the curious circumstances following the exciting conclusion of our St. Patrick's Day adventure.
Really?
Yeah.
A leprechaun took our clothes.
And you can never tell anyone, okay?
Do you want to see your dad?
He's not coming.
But do you want to see him?
No.
Then why aren't you leaving?
Because I don't care, and I'm not going to let him think that I care.
Your dad or Pierce?
There is no dad. Get this thing out of my face. And don't you dare intercut this with footage of me freaking out.
And seriously, I need you to keep a tight, heavy lid on the little Indian girl story.
Sure.
Tight, heavy lid.
Cool. THL.
Annie!
Why were you grilling her?
Listen. I'm gonna bust into her apartment. Do you have any grappling hooks?
Maybe Pierce finally found his soulmate.
How can you say those things without any trace of irony?
That's why they call me Irony Free Annie.
Trust me, that's not what they call you.
Thank you. Thank you.
I'd like to offer my sincere congratulations. It's hard enough to find people you can stay into this life, let alone someone who's willing to stomach your imminent dementia and present incontinence.
Thank you, Jeff. I just hope she can satisfy me. I'm like an insatiable baboon in the bedroom.
Don't sell yourself short. You're a baboon everywhere.
Hello. I hear you're fighting with your study group.
Correct.
Now, you won't know this, being American, but tonight, Liverpool are playing
Manchester United. I'm a stylish American, Professor. I've been forcing myself to be into soccer since 2004.
Friends that you made. They're your true family now.
When you improvise a plan, sometimes you hit a speed bump, and sometimes you hit it so hard that you soar through the air, far beyond your initial expectations.
It might not shock you guys to hear the real reason we had a fight today. It wasn't about the bare naked ladies, although I do have some unresolved issues there. Caring about a person can be scary. Caring about six people can be a horrifying, embarrassing nightmare, at least for me. But if I can't say it today, when can I say it? I love you guys. Oh, and Pierce, take it from an expert. These knuckleheads are right outside your heart. Let them in before it's too late. Happy Valentine's Day.
What? Hey!
That kid in there is severely depressed.
Oh, yeah, is that what he told you? From the looks of it, he's been using that line since he was 5 years old to get an extra slice of pie.
What the hell is wrong with you?
I don't like being excluded, Jeff, do you?
Yes! Now go in there and tell him you're giving him his sword or you are out of the study group.
I'm sick of you threatening me and talking to me like a kid. And giving me that look you give me like I can't get erections.
What?
What are we doing?
Yeah, what are we doing?
This is a bad idea, right?
Yeah.
No, Britta left her phone. She's getting a text message.
Let me see. Oh, it's from Marcus. I'll be at the show tomorrow night. Can't wait to see you. Are you really wearing a cat costume? Well, Marcus, you are in luck.
What are you doing?
Dragging Britta, kicking and screaming into 1997.
What did you say?
There's not much to the cat costume, but can't wait to show you what's underneath.
How could you think that was a good idea?
I got a better question. How could it not be a great idea?
Can do. I'm just a horrible guy.
Guess I'll have to go get laid.
Well, guess what? Annie's got a gun.
Annie, just put the gun.
Records. And before you can say 1984, the Thought Police are forcing you to bend and spread.
Bend and spread? Are the Thought Police gonna make love to us?
Do they find thoughts in our butts?
Okay. You just became my hero.
Thank you.
Annie, relax.
No, you relax, Jeff. Or are you scared that if you do, my pen will fall out?
You precocious little bitch!
Okay, guys.
Can't tell you how great I feel right now.
I wasn't sure that you would take to the trampoline's ways. Some can't. And some are just natural jumpers.
See you tomorrow, Joshua.
We better bounce.
What's up with you guys? Why are you acting like that?
Like what?
Ah! Gay boots! Lady boots! He's a gay wad.
Are those as comfortable as they look?
They're like wearing a pair of dreams. I'm sure your shoes are fine, though.
You know what? They are.
Something's up with you two, and I want to know what it is. Are you on weed? Give me some. I'll smoke you two under the table.
Is anyone coming to get Leonard?
I don't know.
No. Nobody comes for him anymore. His kids asked us to stop calling them. Why do you think he acts like that?
So we're in prison, right?
Great job up there, Captain.
Really? Do you think I could be a real astronaut someday?
Well, if NASA ever needs someone to keep an arrow inside of a moving rectangle, I know who I'd recommend.
Oh, you got a Band-Aid on your arm. You should be more careful shaving.
I wax, dummy. This is from a blood test.
Oh, no. I knew it. Things are going too well for you.
Oh, no, no. Just a physical. Even a Ferrari needs a tune-up. Professor, what would you say might be the difference between a religion and a cult?
Why don't we open that question to the floor, since I don't know, and the book for this class is expensive.
Well, I would say a cult might, for instance, sell you a tube of Jell-O and tell you your mother is in it.
Jeffrey!
Why is everyone wearing those hats? Is the dean planning another ridiculous event, or is the Greendale Hat Club still struggling to be noteworthy?
You're talking about it.
Jeff, you know what lawyers call someone who defrauds the state bar, cheats on his LSATs, and cons his way into a firm? Best lawyer ever.
Seriously?
Hey, tomorrow night, office party, you're my guest.
Hey, Jeff, I'm sure you know Philip. Did you know that if I sleep with Philip once a month, I can use his beach house in Rio whenever I want?
Wow, you guys are really onto something. I think you found the world's newest profession.
Are you jealous because we're fitting in with your cool friends?
No, I'm distracted watching you mutate. Britta, you're not a whore. Shirley, Jesus turned the other cheek. He didn't garnish wages. Pierce, do I even need to say this? It is bad to hunt man for sport.
Badass.
Jeffrey.
Jeffrey, wait.
Dean, what are you... Oh, you smoked the floor of a movie theater.
Yeah, but not for the usual reasons. I have had the worst day. Our dance photo didn't come out. Someone moved my stapler. And worst of all, I hurt you. But you'll be happy to know that we'll be offering another history class. Because I care about you. And not because I found out that if we don't offer a real history class, we'll lose like $40,000 in grant money.
Thank you, Dean. By the way, you didn't have to come all this way to tell me that.
Oh, no, it wasn't a problem. It's on my way.
Please tell me you're breaking into that condo.
No, I bought it. Now we'll be like almost roomies. Oh, good, you got wine. I've got friends with benefits. No subtext. I don't know why I was so worried about change. This year's gonna be great. I'll be right over.
Pretty freaky deaky, huh?
Annie, no. I meant the boxing match ring girl. They're the sexy ones that hold the round numbers.
Yeah, see, this is why we can't just text about it, Jeff. I don't watch sport.
For you, the only thing Pierce is trapped in is adolescence. He is a geriatric toddler throwing the most elaborate tantrums money can buy, and I, for one, am not going to stand by and allow some lonely, ridiculous person to derail our group's plans.
Dean, 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 to your corners, fighters! Someone save me a towel!
You guys going to Vicky's party? We just got to do this thing first. Hey, Annie, sad news. They closed the ski slopes. A dozen scouts got buried in an avalanche. So sad. I say we cut our losses and head home.
What? Why? We're already here. We can still have fun hanging out at the convention.
I'd have more fun hanging out with the parents that are circling the block.
Jeff, why are people staring at you?
Because I've never seen a man who's had sex before.
All right, how many of those do you have in your chamber?
Enough for the whole ride home. What?
We wanted it to be a surprise.
You bear a striking resemblance to Inspector Spacetime supervillain, Thoraxis.
Okay, now we're definitely leaving. The only thing spooky about this place is the tacky decor. It's like David Lee Roth threw up Miami Vice. Oh, so tacky.
I don't know. What the hell is going on here? Suddenly our marriage isn't worth repairing?
What?
Wait! Nigel is married? That is so Thoraxis.
And your American accent isn't at all convincing.
Troy said...
Chris's bedroom is the third door on the left. I didn't leave my short-term memory at Coachella.
Jeez, where? Keep it above the belt.
Sorry.
I've already forgotten.
This house is getting to me.
I know. Kind of weird that a dead person used to live here.
No, what's weird is that a living person lived here with his parents well into his 60s, then they died, and he's still here like a paralyzed Peter Pan.
Not me.
Quick impression. Wah, who am I? You guys. Ha, dead on. Now, how does one search for a red notebook that doesn't exist without looking, touching, or creating future nightmares?
I'll check the nightstand.
Al Dean, pilgrims.
Is that John Wayne?
Yes. Oh, good.
You had a moment of doubt, and here I am to help you through it. Psychology tells us there are no accidents.
Oh, really? What about car accidents, Tara Reid, or the Hindenburg?
Here goes nothing.
You should all drop by, or Jeff, or whoever.
Oh, he can't. He has plans.
Oh, right. You were spending Thanksgiving with your father.
Whoa!
I thought I told you to stop reading my email.
Yeah? Well, I thought I told you to stop keeping secrets. How am I supposed to keep track of what you tell me in confidence and what I hear through your walls with a glass to my ear?
Look, you're probably feeling a very strong urge to sleep with me right now, and that is normal.
Sure.
Britta, thank you. You were right. You're not gonna get all jock jams on me, are you?
No, of course not. I left my boombox at school.
No! Jeez. You gotta stop doing that.
Thank you.
Come here, brother.
Oh,
come here, brother.
Wow. Why don't you save some for Christmas, buddy, okay?
Stop.
Oh, Dean Jeffrey.
Dean, I told you not to come into the teacher's lounge. You're supposed to be in Dean class.
How can I learn to be Dean if I can't hang out with teachers?
Oh, we're supposed to be shaping minds, but we keep shaping each other. Bring it in. Annie, I'm home.
Hey there. How was your day? Did anything funny happen?
Oh, who cares? How was your day?
Good. Sebastian did some drawing.
Sebastian? Let's look at him. Sebastian!
Sebastian!
Oh, back to your child area.
Oh. Get it.
I love you. Are you okay?
Is this really what you want?
Of course. I mean, I'd be fine with a dog, too. But whatever you want.
Do you have any idea what I want?
Yes. I want to fall asleep on a beach and be able to walk the next day. Or stay up all night on accident. I want to wear a white t-shirt without looking like I forgot to get dressed. I want to be terrified of AIDS. I want to have an opinion about those boring-ass Marvel movies. And I want those opinions to be of any concern to the people making them.
You don't need perfect people to make a perfect team. You need people whose flaws feed into each other. It's, what do you call it?
Codependence.
Synergy. For instance, there might be something Britta hates doing, but Annie loves doing. Or there might be something that Annie hates doing, but she does it anyways because what she really loves is to feel useful.
You literally just defined codependence.
Here's to synergy. Oh, look at you, you little helper.
Stop that. What are you doing? Go back to class.
Your player's playing paintball.
No, he's not.
Think about it or don't think about it or don't do it.
Grow up. What are you doing? I'm not playing.
Well, guy who's not playing, you sure are shooting a bunch of mothers.
That was instinct. I can't help being a badass, but I am not playing.
The fiberglass will preserve body heat.
What's wrong with me if that's hot?
Maybe it has something to do with crabs. They like a food, but they're also a disease.
You know, I wonder, Jeffrey, for all your feather flashing, when was the last time you actually scored?
Well, I don't know the precise date, Pierce, because I'm not you, so there's no receipt.
Ooh.
Yeah, I can see that. This is a lot of outgoing calls. Car wash redhead, tube top REM concert, juror number 6. That sounds above board. At least you have mommy in here.
It's not my mom.
Dude, not cool.
Your assistant. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Is she single? What are her likes and dislikes?
Yes, on single. She likes hip hop and horses, dislikes beards, and yeah, I was done talking.
Is it me, or are horses the most beautiful creatures? They're so majestic.
Totally.
I mean, just this morning when I was shaving and listening to the new Jay-Z, I was thinking about how I want to squeeze in a quick gallop this weekend.
Do you own a horse?
Can you ever really own a horse?
A really awesome body. You probably hear that all the time.
Not as much as I should.
Ah. Oh, Professor.
What? I'm not a professor.
But you're at Greendale, and you're old.
I'm a student.
Yikers.
Yeah, it's pretty much yikers for me, too.
Well, I guess I can make an exception, Professor.
What are you, an idiot?
Okay, we get it. You and the A-team are awesome. Now beat it.
Oh, look at that. Pretty boy standing up for Birdface over here. Give me a winner doodle.
If you're trying to be menacing, maybe don't call the cookie by its name.
Oh, you're funny. You're a funny man. Want to hear something funny, funny man? Knock, knock. My fist up your balls.
Who's there?
This is a subject that breeds conflict. Can we please do
what religion are you, Jeff?
I'm agnostic.
Agnostic. Lazy man's atheist.
Look at that. Forehead's taking a test.
Why'd you get going, Chuck Norris?
Did you just shoo me?
Why didn't you just kiss him already?
Dude, I will shoo your nose down your throat.
Senior Chang, can you do something about this?
I'll allow it.
Mary!
Holiday.
Actually, I was gonna say merry semester and happy new one.
Jeff, it's the registrar's office. Seems you were wrong about paying tuition with airline miles. We're gonna need a check, but...
Message deleted. Jeff Winger, I am calling you. You're probably... whatever. So, what's up?
Lunes, martes, miércoles, viernes.
No, 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 no,
no, I hate you. I hate your study group. I hate it. You suck!
And you are not running that story.
Why not?
Because I said so. Does anybody have a problem with how that was handled?
No, no, no.
Exactly the way I would have done it, Jeff.
Thanks for eating all the macaroni.
Shut up, Leonard. Nobody even knows what you're talking about.
But you're different.
Well, you know, she's no barrel of monkeys. She wants everyone to be honest, but she lies to herself. She's seen the world, but doesn't get it. She has more fights about stuff that doesn't matter than a YouTube comment section. She's passionate, which I find stupid, but entertaining.
Attractive?
It was only attraction at first because she bothered to play hard to get.
Hmm.
The chords. See, that's G, that's the most important chord. In my mind, it stands for God.
Why is Annie talking to micro nipples?
Very funny. You know, when you called me last night and invited me to the dance, I was shocked. Thrilled. Are you okay?
Yeah. No, no, look, I'm sorry. I don't remember asking you to the dance. I don't remember anything. And now Slater knows about all the drunk dialing stuff and I'm in the doghouse, and if she finds out about this, it's over. So again, I am sorry. I am so, so sorry. And you are messing with me right now, aren't you?
I know you didn't remember anything from that phone call last night.
You're here to save me, aren't you?
Let's get out of here and never look back.
Jeff, in case you ever have to remember me, can I give you some options for voiceover quotes?
Shut up, Abed.
M'lady?
M'lord.
What did you do?
Don't worry about it. Let's go.
Abed, outside. There is no story.
Everything's a story, Jeff. Getting out of bed is a story. Certainly this is a story. I mean, start with the study room. We're content. I'm concerned. Skip the fruit matching stuff. Dean enters with the insurance appraiser story. Call, refusal. You're literally dragging me across a threshold demanding there be no story, which puts me into a whole new world that I'm gonna have to adapt to.
We have to do it by yourself, please, okay? Because if this appraisal is a story, that means we're in trouble. And we are not in trouble. Because if we are...
no more stories.
Ta-da.
Because once the internet knows about something, it changes.
Right. Just ask Chris Brown or China.
Jeff, you made Annie cry!
Well, if it's any consolation, this is the last time that will ever happen.
Line.
Hey,
His eyes are opening.
Yeah, but that happens when people die, too.
Ooh.
Jeff!
Wait, Britt! Jeffrey! Slap him!
Jeffrey, it's me, the Dean. I'm right here.
Wait, no, no. I think you have
to. Oh, stop it. I'm awake.
Jeff, you've been keeping your birthday a secret?
Yeah, most people have cake, not a fifth of scotch, and what the hell else?
Age reverse, life extend, power. This is Korean.
Okay, what am I?
Chinese!
Okay, I swear to God, I feel Korean.
Guys, I'm 40.
Wow.
I'm not part of this. I am Joseph Gordon Diehard, and I am only here to hug my father, which I now do.
It's a trick.
I'm not letting him hug me.
I hug my father.
He has gunpowder in his pants.
I draw my sword. Stay back.
I draw an arrow.
So do I.
Troll sound. Jeff, do you lower your sword?
No.
Dean, are you?
I hug my father.
You're impaled.
Good Lord.
I'll do it.
Really?
Yeah, Annie always goes from the easy chores to the hardest.
That's true, isn't it?
I'll do it too.
Yeah, me too.
Okay, that concludes this meeting.
No!
Oh, man.
Nobody picks up on my patterns. What am I gonna say next? Graham Cracker, you didn't know.
Hey, it's the couple.
Aww.
I can do tomorrow. I can't.
I'm free on Fridays and Mondays.
We're not moving it! When Shirley can have dinner, we'll have another dinner. Because it's just dinner. And there's no need to manipulate each other. I mean, you know that's what you do. You know you're doing it now with that face.
You don't like my face?
Dion Stock and Trivial Pursuits Baby Boom Edition. My name is Jeff Winger. I recently became a 4. Funny thing is, when I was a 2, I didn't actually have any less. But I did have a lot of crazy friends. Hey, my name's Tommy DeLuca. I'm from hallway C. I'm a 2. I gotta get to the cafeteria before they run out of apples.
Happy?
Are you happy?
Look, I knew you couldn't go to that stupid dinner. That's why I didn't invite you.
It's nice to be invited anyway.
Sure, if you're a control freak.
Oh, and you clearly hate control.
No. I love it. I guess it's easy to pretend that you don't when you got it.
You'd think we'd be better friends because we're both such big fans of the same thing.
You there, ones! You are permitted back indoors by decree of Britta, the mother of ones.
Please help me seduce Britta now that you've finished doing it with her. Please, please.
Do you even really like Britta? It seems like you like her because she doesn't like you.
Have you met the women that do like me, Jeff? Neither have I, but trust me, they're bad people.
Fine. To get near Britta, think like Britta. Grab one of those free papers for hippies on the quad, go to the calendar page, and find a cause so tragic. Are you writing this down? I should introduce myself to her friends and...
I knew it! You don't have a drinking problem. You have feelings for Britta, you disgusting monster.
Fine. Yes, something about everybody liking her turns me on. Oh. It's a problem I have. I hated Reese's Pieces before E.T. ate them. Sorry.
You're a bad friend.
That's not fair. Wait, that's really not fair. You're a terrible friend. She was mine first. And it's not like she belongs to anybody.
Oh, here we go. Love isn't a game, say the guys that always win. And now you're gonna go pull a Dane Cook in one of those 3 movies he was in about Dane Cook getting laid by accident. Only, it's not a Dane Cook movie, Jeff, because this time someone's watching. Me, your friend, British Jason Biggs.
If you never call me Dane Cook again, I'll stand down. For an hour.
Okay. An hour.
Then imagine what the floor looks like.
I don't have to. I'll just imagine where you're about to be.
That's the same as imagining the floor.
Then you just admitted that's where you'll be.
Knock, knock, Britta.
I'm not gonna say who's there because someone on the floor is knocking.
Well, that's lame. You have to say who's there.
Floor!
What?
That's who's there!
Yeah, but it's for you!
for an ideal.
Well, maybe a fraction of a butt cheek on the line. I mean, it's not like I use that stupid Greendale email for anything but porn subscriptions and improv show mailing lists.
What makes you think it's only your Greendale email they'll be leaking?
Because they hacked Greendale.
You have a computer in your office?
Yes.
Do you check your emails on that computer?
Uh-huh.
You look at boobies on it?
One time.
They got it. They got everything. It's Vietnam now, baby. It's Vietnam!
Hey, Jeff.
Hey. Hey, here you can have my seat. I'm just going to class.
Oh, wait, before you go. I know you have every one of Natalie's freezing CDs, but Abed found some songs by them online that they did for a charity album for homeless skateboarders.
Plastic doll parts, wallpaper chrysalis. Weird blanket. I never heard these. This is great. Thanks.
Hey, stay away from that mechanic.
Unless I need a wrench made of licorice.
I'm sorry, inside joke. Man, I'm like a fart to that guy. He can't get away fast enough.
What? No. I mean, maybe.
What the hell happened at that ears game that made him like you so much?
A few brief moments of human vulnerability. Not really your wheelhouse.
Oh, I'm sure you have detailed files on human vulnerability, Abed.
What? Oh.
Whoa, take a knee, man.
He's right, Jeff. If you want Elroy to like you, maybe you need to put yourself out there.
You mean bribe him? With gifts? Like your Natasha Freezes CD?
Mm. Natalie is freezing.
Ugh. Natalie is freezing. It's pretty creepy, Elroy.
Oh, you guys are so suave. You're such a gentleman. You and Chang have a daily email chain ranking Annie and Britta 1 and 2.
By which you mean Chang emails me rankings every day and I don't respond.
Except for February 7th, 2013. Chang, Britta is 1, Annie is 2. Jeff, ha, yeah. Jeff, gross.
Elroy, I'm tired of playing this game. I like you and I want you to like me.
Okay. You're a good guy, Jeff Winger. You and I are going to be friends.
Okay, great, whatever.
I love you. I love you. I love you. I love you, I love you, I love you. I love you, I love you.
What are you doing?
Nothing at all.
I wouldn't say that. You just put 5 huge cans of olives next to me.
Just something I felt like doing.
This isn't the first time you've done this. I'm really confused by this. Is it code for something?
I don't know. And I don't care.
Jackpot.
Are you trying to murder me? You're trying as hard as you can right now to kill me. Okay, well, I guess I'll see you in class tomorrow.
Oh, go write an astronaut. Oh, did anyone see Jeff's letters? He writes to astronauts. Talk about creepy.
They're national heroes!
Yes, they are! Leave them alone!
Oh, that
owes its continued existence to the following heroes. Jeff Winger, a teacher so dedicated to clean energy, he's already parking like his car is electric.
You did it, Jeff Winger. This is your school now. Annie.
It was worth it. Gives him death.
Hey, watch it, punk.
What are you, 80?
He's the one trying to bring back disco. I don't have to be old to know it's not gonna happen.
Thanks for a great year.
Mr. Winger! I hope you will be seizing the day this summer.
Thanks, Professor Whitman. And I hope you'll be seizing a more contemporary movie. Looking good, Leonard. Stroke or Tai Chi?
Tai Chi.
Keep it up. And keep up whatever it is you're doing, Garrett.
It's called chillaxing.
Duh.
Hey, what's up, Jeff? Hi.
Hello, good morning. Howdy.
Don't get too high on your own drama.
High on my own drama? People's champion!
Jeff Winger. You son of a bitch.
guidelines for school-sanctioned pranks. Reminds me of my favorite college comedy.
Oh, which one?
Exactly. Would you stop tuning that guitar? You are 105 years old. Tell me exactly what you did with your life to end up here so I don't make the same mistakes.
Excuse me!
Every day you flock here like sheep and wait in line for a broken promise from a dirty system.
Back in those days, Jeff Winger was the guy that made things happen. He always knew what to say, and he always knew when to slap the table.
You want to be sheep? Keep flocking. You want to be wolves? Form a pack.
That was it. It was that simple. At that moment, we stopped being a family and started being a family in italics.
Why waste your time envying my gift for levity when there's so much you could be doing with your natural talent for severity?
You know what? My prank is going to cause a sea of laughter, and I'm going to watch you drown in it.
That a girl.
Checkmate, bitches. And tell the drama club their tears will be real today. Just take a picture, it'll last longer.
Cool.
Oh!
Gay, so gay.
Dark nightclub, throbbing music.
Men's room stall.
We're doing fine on our own.
Yeah? You gonna win the whole game camped on a crapper?
Worked on you.
Did it? Or do you have a gun in your face?
Yeah, kind of matches yours.
Nice comeback.
Shut up!
Jeez.
Oh my God. Is she wearing a Discman? How could you do this to me?
What? Discmans are retro.
Oh.
Spanish has value beyond credit.
Not really. I know the family downstairs hates me. I don't need to understand why.
Okay, fine.
I guess I just love you too much.
Not half as much as me.
Please tell me you didn't have sex with me to win at paintball.
No, I had sex with you, and now I'm gonna win at paintball. Don't be gross.
I'm gross. You seem pretty practiced at putting on panties one-handed while holding a gun.
Accident.
I knew it. Nicely done.
If I come forward, it's gonna play into the whole Britta's a buzzkill mythology.
Well, the toe tag fits, Britta. I mean, you single-handedly killed an entire school's buzz, not to mention a frog. And according to Glenda, Cadaver Harry had 13 nieces and nephews that I'm not interested in meeting. So you better think about coming clean, or I'm just gonna tell everybody you did it.
So I can mortgage your
face! Hey, break it up!
Ah! Oh, hey! Oh, we're writing a song!
It's the Battle of the Bands!
Who can confirm that?
Your mama.
What?
Well, I mean. I don't want to sound like a defeatist, but we're defeated.
Oh, come on, Jeff.
Face it. Why even take the exam? We're all going to be retaking Spanish this fall.
I wouldn't threaten the monkey. They have more lactic acid than us.
Oh, my God. Almost.
What do you want from me, Jeffrey?
Guess. You heard Chang tell me he was bogus, and then drop the dime because you would do anything to keep this group together. Because you are insecure. Because you didn't get hot until after high school.
That's true.
Fine! I did it. For real, Annie?
Oh, Annie.
Guys, have you considered the new Pierce concept is stupid?
Spoken like the new Pierce.
Right. You're so
I'm not the new Pierce.
Oh, so I tell you that I love you, and then you go outside and stick your tongue into a teenager.
What is wrong with you, Jeffrey?
Well, Shirley, since you have clearly failed to grasp the central insipid metaphor of those Twilight books you devour, let me explain it to you. Men are monsters who crave young flesh. The end. At least we have the decency to be ashamed of it and keep it a secret instead of publicly blurting, I love you, to everyone who sleeps with us.
Oh, please, I never loved you.
Ah-ha! I win! I win! win, I win in your face.
So this was all a game?
Hey, man, how's it going? Don't shoot the messenger, but everyone at this dance is kind of waiting for your reaction to all this.
Look, I'm trying to think, okay?
Yeah, that's cool. Take your time. Hey, how's it going? You look great. Very fatal attraction.
Mr. Winger.
Cagney, Lacey, what can I do you for?
Just doing a routine search.
What is this? What do you have here?
What's this?
That's my chest.
Yeah. I just fat him.
Huh? What would you back in here?
Guys?
Huh? I can pat too. I can do it too. So, what do you got in the back?
Yeah.
What the?
Let's see what we have here. Holy Mary, mother of pearl. What do we have here?
It's like enough tiny items to equip an amphibious mariachi band.
Of frogs.
That is not my stuff.
Hmm.
Britta. Britta planted that.
Sure she did.
Tell that to what our equivalent of a judge is.
Now she's going to make the Disney face. Her lip is going to quiver and her eyes will flutter, but they won't ever actually close. But do not feel sorry for her. She stole a year of our lives and we're right to be pissed.
Oh, Annie.
No! No! Everyone close their eyes. Do it. Close them. Abed, close.
Oh, don't worry about me. I can only connect with people through movies.
She's the Ark of the Covenant.
I'm going to use this to attack you, and you use respect to defend yourself.
Oh my God,
I respect you.
That's why you fail.
I just figured out how. Can we focus on what's important here? Shirley thinks we don't care about her.
No, you're right. That's totally more important. I just thought of one thing. You need to bang that kid's mom.
After we fix everything with Shirley.
Whoa! Yes, we'll deal with Shirley, but that's brilliant!
What are you waiting for?
What Shirley said really made me think. I mean, all my friends believe this guy. What does it say about me that I don't?
Yes. Ugh. And cue Wet Blanket Winger to tell us that we're all wasting our time.
Actually, no. I had a really good conversation with Shirley, and I realize I've been acting like a jerk. If it's not too late, I'd love to help out in any way I can.
Jeffrey, that's amazing. I knew you'd come around. All right, Abed, get us in panning singles. And can you say powwow instead of conversation? Just sounds more you. All right, action. Okay, you can make an entrance? Great.
What does it say? It says I have gullible friends who will believe anybody, and I need to make that anybody me. By exposing Chang in front of the whole school. Wow. In the unlikely event I fail to expose Chang, I'm pretty confident Pierce will make sure we don't get a grant.
What you talking about, Honky?
Wow. That bit could not get any more perfect.
Wait a minute. I haven't introduced you to my Asian wife yet.
I was wrong.
Ooh, get involved.
No. I am here to replace my fake bachelor's so I can get back to my life as a lawyer. Nobody else is sacrificing their interests. Don't ask me to sacrifice mine.
Don't ask me to sacrifice mine. That's you just now.
You know how crazy and paranoid he can get.
Aha! Crazy, paranoid, impotent.
Cellular.
I knew you'd run to Jeff and turn him against me.
Mitosis.
God. Now, if you like this idea, you can make it true by doing something good for everyone here. Throw this case out of court. It's dumb. That is all.
This Fallujah of higher learning is a prison from which none of us will ever escape.
Okay, Jeffrey, now we're mixing metaphors.
And it turns out that Starburns, this man in this urn, was a hero to us the whole time because he did the one thing that none of us ever tried to do. He got out.
If you tell anyone we did this, I will stop letting you do things with me I'm afraid to tell anyone about.
Hey, I get it. You want to take a look at Britta's ex-boyfriend? If you get it by yourself, you'd be weird.
You're the only one that really understands me.
Oh, funky.
Ricky Nightshade, the rock and roll magician.
I'm starting. I need a volunteer.
I'll kill anyone who raises their hand.
Whoa. Wow. Jeez. Halloween dance, post-Halloween dance, dance contest, contest dance. Oh, come on. What's this? Save Garrett? What's wrong with Garrett?
Nothing now. We saved him.
Wait, that saved Garrett?
Ooh. What's this? Love letter?
Oh, it's probably one of many.
Oh, no, this is a hate letter.
What? Let me see that. Dear Jeff, this may come as a shock to someone who thinks he's God's gift to the world, but you're actually an inconsiderate jerk, Kim. Inconsiderate?
Who's Kim?
I don't know. And clearly she doesn't know me. Word got around these two were now hurting each other's feelings. And I thought about what Annie said, and then I thought about what I might do to make things right.
I love that I have a locker now. All that wasted time going to my car for mid-afternoon wardrobe adjustments.
What do you think? Stick with what's working?
You're gonna change your shirt?
Not if it's working.
It's not working.
Yeah.
You're right.
I knew it.
I love what she's having.
Hey, grow up, lady! Jeff! I looked it up. I was right.
Oh, that thing about Danny Thomas? I looked it up, too. Weird.
No, those meds you're taking. Without anxiety to keep your vanity in check, you are vulnerable to a syndrome called hypernarcissosis. Okay, look. This apple is your ego. Imagine it expanding to the point of critical mass, taking over your whole personality, making you an uncontrollable monster.
Britta, how did an apple make that clear? Imagine it expanding? Use a balloon.
I was on my way to lunch.
Why are you trying to take this away from me? I like having no anxiety. I'm in harmony with the world.
Looking good, Winger.
Thank you, Leonard, for that compliment and for your service to this country. I'm so confident now, I can pull things off I never dreamed possible. Look. Aviators. Final boarding call, Beefcake Airways.
I'm warning you as your friend to get off of those meds. And until they're out of your system, stay away from flattering situations, weddings, soft lighting, formal wear, gay bars, and take those off.
Because they make me look good.
Hey, look, buddy. I know it must have sucked being Colonel Sanders' manservant and all, but Pierce is technically our friend, and we're not going to watch you screw him over.
Perhaps you should be asking yourselves how you intend to stop me.
Jeff, what are you doing here?
I just got back from the carnival, where I met Blade.
Is he okay? How is he?
He's brain damaged.
Well, let's not be petty.
No, I'm serious. He showed me the scar. 10 years ago, before he even met you, a loose bolt flew off a Ferris wheel and embedded in his skull, destroying the part of his brain that feels shame. I mean, he's basically irresistible to people for the same reason he can pretty much only work at a carnival. He has nothing to prove or disprove about himself or to himself. He has no shame.
Why wouldn't he have told me that?
Because he didn't care if you knew.
That is so like him. Thank God, Shirley, it's just you and me now. Jeff?
Trees, you finally have one thing I actually need, and...
way back to where they were supposed to be. One was crumpled up a bit, that was Troy's. The other was just a little dusty, that was Abed's. I fixed him up, even though I was the only one watching. Because I settled on a truth today that's always going to be true. I would do anything for my friends, which I think is how everyone in the world feels, which finally makes me understand war.
Wait, you won't spend money on a name brand phone, but you got LASIK for your geriatric cat?
He only has the one eye, Jeff. I can't exactly buy him a cat monocle, can I? It's pretentious.
Your friends from intruders.
How does it work?
Your guests have arrived. Threat level 4. Your guests have arrived.
It's not calibrated.
Wireless racism. The future of the past is now.
What?
You're right. I can feel my ego taking over. Do something!
Okay, listen to me. You are not that big of a deal. Do you understand? You have bad posture. When you do too many push-ups, it looks like you have boobs. The tile in your bathroom is tacky. You were emotionally closed off in bed to the point where one time I didn't come up because I couldn't find close enough parking. You have an unusually high butt crack.
Thank you.
Boopy-doopy-doop, boop sex.
You were Big Cheddar?
Who told you that? Oh, dear Lord.
Annie, I need your help. You're like sentimental and stuff. I'm really having trouble coming up with a toast.
I find that hard to believe, Jeff. You once convinced Troy that turtlenecks were made of turtles' necks.
It's true. My superpower is that I can assume any position that suits my purpose. In that example, keeping turtlenecks as an option for myself down the road. But I do have a kryptonite. It's so obvious to me that marriage is dumb, I can't even pretend to get behind it.
You know what I think would make the perfect toast? You, as Shirley's friend, and a good guy just saying what's really in your heart. There's something real in there. Maybe that's what scares you.
I could use a drink.
I came prepared.
You seem smarter than me when I met you.
Thank you.
Professor. Thank you.
It's not a favor, Mr. Winger. A man's gotta have a code.
Awesome.
May I help you?
I'd like to ask you a few questions, if that's okay. He's bolting! He's there!
If you're going to confiscate this, know one thing. It's a mild, kind sativa. Perfect for playing guitar.
Come on, guys, I got class in 15 minutes. This should not be that difficult. We just need to figure out an idea for our final history project.
What we need to figure out is Greendale's obsession with group assignments. Huh, classic herd mentality.
All right, Britta doesn't have one. Who else?
Mr. Winger, state your name.
Jeffrey Winger.
Are you gay?
No.
Are you sure you're not gay?
Yes.
Gay murder says what?
What?
He's telling the truth.
I've been instructed to point out that that means you're gay. Miss Bennett.
Mm-hmm. Ding, 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 ding. Dean, 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 dean. Catherine, do not even tell me you dropped that cake!
You, red hair. I'm not gonna learn names.
Will there be a syllabus?
Will there be a syllabus is a good example of a question. Moving on. Ski cap.
Are we gonna be graded?
Oh, no spoilers, ski cap. Maybe we better do names.
Dave.
Oh, you unprofessional. I'm punishing you, Jeffrey. Starting next week, you are the new coach of the water polo team.
What?
That's right. Every morning, in the water, Craig Pelton, dean and assistant water polo coach.
What? I am the system. I consume humanity. There is no escape.
Objection!
Jeff Winger, hero at law. Best lawyer you ever saw. Defender of liberty, south of the 40 and Lincoln, you park for free. Jeff,
are you a good person being sued, oppressed, or beaten? I can help, and that's the Winger guarantee.
Smarty pants. I am so excited. Jeff is going to help me save the school. Not all by himself. I am learning Excel. Jeff, do you know Excel?
No.
Well, it looks like you do. Yay, Teachy!
You're scaring me.
Good. Guys like you should be more scared. You trust-funded, body-sprayed Eli Roth DVD owner. You're an amateur monster, Alan. And you stomped in the grave of a real monster who was willing to stay buried. Because real monsters have shame. Because they wished it. You're not worth the monologue. Give me your tie. What? No monologue for you. Give me your tie. That's for making me go to this school. That's for making the last 4 years happen. And now I get to make them unhappen for me and the only people I care about.
Visitors leave things.
Is one of your trophies a pair of Miss Perry's panties?
You told me a hawk stole them! You exploited me and made me believe in a slightly more magical world.
If you want to collect women's underwear, can't you just buy them?
They have to be won in battle.
Gross!
Awesome.
I may not be good with facial expressions, but I know an evil doppelganger when I see one. Plus, your arm makes a noise every time you move it.
Silence!
Are you here to kill Jeff?
Oh, you non-evils are so naive. I'm here to save Jeff from the smothering teat of his study group.
Is that a paintball gun?
You wish.
Cool. Wait. Cold.
Hey, get out of my chair. I'll have you disbarred. Oh, wait, that already happened.
Cash.
Tango. My old partner, my new firm. Oh, does it get any better?
Not unless you leave.
Still got it.
So, a little birdie told me you're graduating Kitty College.
You must be excited to get that lollipop.
Hey, it's a sticker.
Ha! I know you're busy. Not, so allow me to whip it out. Come work with me. You'll be a full partner, six figures, corner office, three secretaries. What's that? Not enough money? I'll double it. Bam, done. That's how we negotiate. Lunch?
Wow, I drive a hard bargain. But Mark, aren't you worried I'm a little out of practice? The only cases I've tried lately are about sandwiches and yams.
Please, you were a better lawyer when you weren't a lawyer than most lawyers I know. It's still in you.
I'll give it some thought.
Just shake my hand, idiot. It's simple.
I like simple.
Take a look around, Winger. This is your new old life.
What's happening? No one's here. The dean is mad at me, and he is never mad at me. And a third reason.
Congratulations, Jeff. Don't worry about the study group. You can talk to them later. Why don't you and I go celebrate someplace private and boozy?
Annie, why are you acting like a mistress in a Lifetime movie?
And Mr. Winger is a teacher. You know what that means? It means he gets you meatballs.
Oh, please. That's all I have.
Get out of here. Place is a zoo. The trick is, you gotta show the other baboons you got a bigger, redder ass. Let's hit the line.
Okay, you two need to let go of the pressure you're putting on this project to get an A.
I'm supposed to be number one!
Sorry.
Or me!
Sorry.
Friendship!
Cold.
Looks as if you've lost your way.
Pierce?
Continue on this path, and you might miss your last chance to see the Pierce Hawthorne Museum of Gender Sensitivity and Sexual Potency on the Central Quad. The museum and this hologram were donated in compliance with a court order I'm not allowed to discuss.
Let's just say some women can't take a compliment.
What I am allowed to discuss is Greendale. And I'll say this, don't turn your back on it. Take it from a man with no legal right to be there. You're in a special place. A crappy place, sure, but only because it gives crappy people a chance to sort themselves out. Did I sound gay at the end?
I need you to give this DVD to Troy and Abed.
Oh, I love those movies. They should make more of them. They're a timeless tale. Why can't you give it to them?
Troy and Abed think they switched bodies while holding onto a Freaky Friday DVD, which, of course, is now mysteriously missing, and they can't switch back until they find it. Now, I'd give them this one myself, but they'll think that I bought it. Which I did.
Wait, how did they switch bodies?
They held onto the DVD and said,
I wish I could switch places with you for just one day.
Sorry, routine light switch check.
That is not a thing.
What?
Hey, handsome.
Was indeed down by the stables.
Damn, yeah, man. Did you ever heard a knocking?
Yep, just heard it when I did it a second ago.
They've seen too much. Let's kill them.
Stand down, Crazy Smith. What we're doing here is none of their business. We have murder mystery night during the day.
I was fine with none of your business.
Notice that each puppet is made in your likeness. They were a rush job. It's not like I had them on hand for personal use. Excuse me, let me just grab this thing that's definitely not a whip. In addition,
I'll give you eyes up.
Jeff, my man, congrats on getting your case thrown out. Your argument was a masterpiece.
I mean, it was definitely creative.
Creative? He convinced the judge to forgive 5 years back taxes by getting him to agree that you humping an American flag to Back in Black was not stripping, but actually not-for-profit performance art? Boom!
blew me away.
Come on, let's go! Thank you. Thank you for defending a woman's right to use her body however she chooses.
I can honestly say that right is very important to me.
Oh.
Excuse me, Mr. Ware, can we get a closer?
You're a hero. Hi.
Hi. I was thinking we could swing by this great barber shop I know. You're looking a little stubbly, and nobody handles a razor like an Italian. They develop nimble fingers from pleasing their mistresses.
Thank you for opening my eyes to two new stereotypes. Now, how can I put this? No, I don't want to go. Not now, not ever. No.
No prob.
It wouldn't have happened if you hadn't decided a C minus isn't good enough. When are you gonna grow up and realize that grades don't matter outside of school?
That's a lie they tell dumb people when they're fitting them for work boots.
All we needed was a passing grade, and we had it until you dragged us into this mess.
Judge Avery's.
That makes no sense.
Also, I didn't like the way you were being such a jerk to her.
Well, she was acting crazy.
Yeah, but what choice does she have? You make fun of her, you use her name as a synonym for screwing up. Cut her some slack, Jeff. She helped you reconcile with your dad. For Pete's sake, let her be happy.
The perfect beginning for my first day of billiards class.
Oh, did you pick a special outfit so you can look sexy shooting pool?
Shirley, I have no idea what you are talking about.
Oh.
13.
Oh, great. So much for
booty.
Because you're hungry?
Guys, I'll be back, but with booty.
Ooh, yeah.
All right. Nobody here is can't buy me loving or love don't cost a thinging anyone. Because we've all seen enough after-school specials and Fat Albert to know that Abed only needs to be himself.
Look at you, all grown up. Jeff, this is my stepdaughter, Amber.
Small world.
No, actually, it's a very big world with 5 billion other women in it. Good luck.
Nobody plays pool like that.
Yeah, well, what do you call this?
I call that your personal business, okay? And I call this class the desecration of America's coolest sport.
Yeah, I see, right there, ha, coolest sport. Okay, I want everybody to know what's going on here. This hipster is dropping this class because he cares more about what he looks like than how he's playing.
Oh, please. You're the one with the rules about clothes. And by the way, I could kick your ass all over that table.
Oh, is that a challenge? Huh? Because if you play me in pool, you play me in shorts. And if you can't do that, my point's already made.
I don't have anything to prove to you. Or look, you're stupid. You're becoming dangerous, Annie. Just those doe eyes. Disappointing you is like choking the Little Mermaid with a bite chain.
This is slightly wrong.
Too much tongue.
Just enough, but it's Pierce.
You mean the guy who decided he doesn't want men touching his ex-stepdaughter, but who divorced my mom for our housekeeper?
Could be the same guy, yeah.
Amber?
Amber, there you are.
Why are you here, Jeff? I go to school here, remember? Researched. You don't even have to make a good pot. You get an art credit for participation. This class is like a redhead that drinks scotch and loves Die Hard. I suggest you all get her number.
Well, of course, yes, you need that.
Did you sleep here?
Only for a few hours. Guess where Rich is from.
Couldn't have been Crazy Town. You'd have gone to high school together.
Santa Fe, New Mexico. Nobody gets out of Santa Fe without learning how to make a pot. 45% Hispanic, fifth highest Native American population. They eat and breathe clay there.
I think some of this research may have been done on Wikipedia.
You're mocking me? You. No. Fine. Go ahead. Mock me.
Oh, Jeff. You're gold blooming.
Gold blooming? I don't know what that means. So, look, I have work to do before class because I want to catch Rich when he slips up.
Who even cares if he's pretending to be a beginner?
Pottery cares. Integrity cares. Look, I don't care. I just care that he cares. It's lame that he cares.
Oh, no. Grifters.
I better wash my French fries unless... Counterfeit? Where'd you learn to do that? I'm the mayor of outer space. Why are we changing course?
The mayor's up my ass.
Father, I love him.
I was on your side. You're an ass.
Well, you're a crofless, artless thug.
No more grifting, and promise, if this is worth a million,
we'll split it.
You an idiot.
Or maybe I'm a genius.
No, I can answer that. You're definitely an idiot.
Can an idiot walk backwards like this and not hit anything?
Maybe.
Or maybe not.
But this is a kind of canvas. I work on it with equipment, but I will never really be done.
Could be if you wanted. I mean, you're fine.
This will never be done. Chris Pratt's never gonna stop, is he? He'll always be out there mocking me. Because it sounds like he was either the victim of crass, artless thuggery.
Correct.
In which case, there really is $50,000 floating around that he was given for clearly fake injuries and that he therefore now owes the school.
What?
Or Professor DeSalvo was targeted by a group of people he vastly underestimated, in which case the money was given and then taken back, and nobody owes anybody anything. All he would have to do is admit.
I was grifted.
But so what? We're gonna get crushed.
I love you?
I love you.
That's your daughter.
You're my daughter.
Yeah, you said we were sisters, dumbass.
It's hot.
Telegram from Mr. Winger.
Hey, Ridley.
So I returned the telegram and outfit to the dean.
Oh, thank you so much. I know how crazy this week's been. You really didn't have to do this.
Are you kidding? I owe you. Whatever you need, just say the word.
All right. I could use your help moving a mattress this weekend.
Okay, cool.
Is that okay?
Let me know.
My name is Ryan Ridley. 3 years ago, my life was saved by a stranger at my gym. I felt like I owed him my life. Apparently, he agreed. Now he has me do things, and I keep hoping and praying that one day I'll do enough for him to call us even. Until then, I'm just a guy from his gym.
Leave me alone, Abed. Once I watch this tutorial on how editing works, I'm gonna save this movie without removing its soul.
I see your value now.
That's the nicest thing anyone's ever said to me.
Okay, Duncan, you did seem less into integrity the day that I convinced 12 of your peers that when you made that U-turn on the freeway and tried to order chalupas from the emergency call box, that your only real crime was loving America.
Well, I do love America. I love it very much.
Duermo tarde, español. Una hora más. No rearme coche.
I really need help with Spanish.
Yeah, I was willing to bet. I'm Jeff. Or Jefe. It'd be too hard to fake a study group, right?
Huh?
Oh, geez, I'm sorry. I was raised on TV, and I was conditioned to believe that every black woman over 50 is a cosmic mentor.
Were you conditioned to pay for your damn tacos, Seinfeld?
Yes, I'm so sorry. Duncan, you don't have to play shrink to protect your pride. I accept. You're chicken.
Are you trying to use reverse psychology on a psychologist?
No, I'm just using regular psychology on a spineless British twig.
I'm a professor. You can't talk to me that way.
A six-year-old girl could talk to you that way.
Yes, because that would be adorable.
No, because you're a five-year-old girl and there's a pecking order.
Fine, I'll do it.
Thank you.
Yeah, pleasure. Bye.
Jeffrey, before you say anything, you may want to think about the gift you've been given.
An excuse to punch a hippie?
No.
I like you, Jeffrey. You remind me of myself at your age.
I deserve that.
I'm sorry I called you Michael Douglas, and I see your value now.
Well, that's the nicest thing anyone's ever said to me.
Well, that's a matter of opinion. Whoever is growing a small patch of cannabis behind the gymnasium, congratulations. You have won a cruise. Report to security to claim your tickets. In order to increase awareness of homelessness...
She said I was cute.
Tell you what, you take her. I have less to prove.
You know, Jeff, you can't pursue people so desperately. It starts to creep them out. Why don't we go get a beer? I'll give you some advice, and we can have what the kids are calling a sausage fest.
I'm not much of a sausage guy, Pierce. Maybe next time.
Next time, then. Can you believe this? What are the odds? It's a nice shirt. Want to sell it?
Yes.
Nice sign.
Thanks. I like what you've done with the place.
I think I was a little too harsh on you. I'm not perfect.
I am. I'd be happy to show you the ropes. Pierce, I got an idea. Why don't you go get a cup of coffee and hold some waitress hostage with a monologue about your sperm?
I'll show you some sperm, buddy.
Okay, guys, why are there costumes involved? These are short conversations. They're not supposed to take...
Your breath away? Well, tough. You ready, amigo?
Si.
Do you like Dan Cook?
Awesome.
So far, so good.
You're new. Yes, I'm new, but I'll be old too soon. Carpe diem, sir. Carpe diem. I like it. I've got problems of my own. I'm out here trying to seize a day. What in the hell? Is he gonna kill us?
Is that everyone should always do whatever they want and leave each other out of it.
Abed is an adult and a U.S. citizen. Right?
Yeah. But every year, there's always one cocky opportunist who's just here to coast and grab an easy A.
Oh, yeah. You need a ride home.
His name's Pierce. I can talk to him.
It's actually you, Mr. Winger. You have no intention of seizing the day.
What? Listen, I have never lived until I met you. I love you.
What do you think, Dad?
I think you are really weird, Abed.
Interesting. I hadn't seen the Iraq metaphor, but... What Iraq metaphor? I'm talking about your speeches and her guy that
got it. The point is that Britta is sorry, right?
Wrong.
Crap.
Boo!
An ordinary coffee for an ordinary life.
Good morning, Professor Whitman.
Sorry, Mr. Winger. These won't cut it.
It's showtime.
Hey, everybody, good morning.
Good morning, sir.
Good morning.
Good morning, Greendale. Hi. Good morning. Watch the kite. Uh-oh. Why do I get a chance? Oh! Look at this. No, 1 foot. Thank you, guys. Bring it in here. Nice. Thank you so much, you guys. That was really fun.
Sloppy. And considering the age of these girls, unwittingly creepy.
Damn it.
Seized!
We're even.
Hey, Britta, hi. What's up?
Hey, Vaughn, how's it going?
No worries.
Interesting, because I might be worried if I was playing hacky sack a decade too late.
Hey, hi, what's up, man?
I'm Vaughn.
You in line? Oh, no. We're just chilling. Hey, you're not gonna order coffee.
No, I was gonna see if Britta...
I mean, no judgment, bro. I used to do coffee. Then I made the switch to green tea. It's like filled with these antioxidants and stuff.
Hmm.
It's pretty tight.
Tight? Yes. I've heard that about green tea.
I like green tea. I should make the change.
Up top, sugar bear.
Yeah, give me some of that.
There it is.
Small coffee, please.
I'm gonna show her that I am not the jerk she thinks I am and friend the hell out of that green tea drinking drum circler.
Okay. But tell me you notice how small his nipples are.
Not engaging.
No, that's not gossip when it's bad.
My kids got hamsters with bigger nips.
No!
Oh, well.
No!
Jeff!
And if I'm occasionally naked in your dreams, I won't complain.
Shirley.
I know. She's got a problem. She stirs the pot. She's a poster. You're the devil.
I know.
The world wasn't the only thing that changed on September 11th.
Oh, come on.
You know, you have the savoir-faire of a hyena. How is it that you and James Bond come from the same island?
Message received. I'll just wait for you to finish striking out first.
Cheers.
Mesh.
Faulty Towers. Game over. Have a nice day.
So, I guess the cell phone number you put on the study group's contact sheet was fake, which I just learned in the awkward conclusion of a month-long text message affair with a dude from Boulder.
Sorry.
That's okay. Just give me a real number. I'll cleanse my palate while Kevin rethinks his marriage.
I'll give you my number if you promise not to use it in any other context than friendship.
Pass.
So... Wow.
Yeah, I bet you're enjoying this.
Yeah, well, when we first met, you were up here and I was here and now... Oh, wait, I gave a quarter to a dirty bum today.
Look at me.
I am.
No, look how handsome my face is.
If all I wanted was sex, I could get it from plenty of women without having to go through all this crap. I'm here because I like you, and I'd be psyched to be your friend. I just didn't want to take sex off the table without doing my due diligence.
I actually believe you.
Well, why wouldn't you?
I can neither confirm nor deny that. See how good I am? Here.
Let me tell you a little secret about me, Troy.
Every day on my way to school, I drive through downtown past the courthouse just to get a glimpse of the world that I once ruled. And I just want to jump out of my car, run up the steps, and exploit the legal system for profit. But I can't. I'm locked out of my old kingdom. You're not. You see what I'm saying?
You're saying I could be a lawyer.
I'm saying you're a football player. It's in your blood.
That's racist.
Your soul.
That's racist.
Your eyes.
That's gay.
That's homophobic.
That's black.
That's racist.
Damn.
Aha! I've been following you. How much did the dean pay you to make Troy play football?
I'm not having a conversation with someone who emerges from a bush.
Because I'm right?
No, because I'm not in a commercial for breakfast cereal. Look, Dean has pictures of me, okay? Horrible pictures of me attending his school.
And for that, you'd convince Troy to flush his life down football's toilet again? Bert is right. You were the most selfish person alive. And all that is going to end right now. Because I'm telling him what kind of friend you really are.
Maybe you should tell him you're hopelessly in love with him. High school must have been tough, huh? Waiting for a superstar to notice you. But here, he's all alone, and he needs so much help. Did you enroll in all of his classes, or were you worried that might freak him out? The important thing is that you are there for him. The important thing is that you are the only one there for him. And you don't really care what he wants, just as long as you don't have to share him with the rest of the world. Because really, you are just as selfish as I am. You're just not as good at it yet.
You're right. I could never be as good as you. Probably because I actually care.
Profound, but technically meaningless. I just think we were both wrong.
Really? Because I'm an 18-year-old girl and you made me cry in public.
Okay, maybe I was a little more wrong.
Bernoulli's one of my favorites.
Little known fact, statistics were not his only love. He's also famous for his French sauce used on meat and poultry.
That's Bernays.
Oh, we may need to settle this at a restaurant.
It's cute. A little aggressive, but as a busy, confident woman of authority, I'm attracted to men who take charge.
Are you being sarcastic, or am I nailing it?
You were nailing it until you had to ask.
Oh, damn it. Starting over. Hey, you in the skirt, date me.
I'd like to, Mr. Winger. You're tall, you dress nice, and I've graded enough of your tests to know I'd never feel mentally inadequate.
Thank you.
Only problem, I don't date students.
This won't work. The last time you did this, I saved a vial of your tears and have been slowly building up an immunity.
It was so unpopular.
Please sleep with me. Please. Pretty please. I'm so lonely. I haven't slept with anyone in a very long time, and you are so good looking. Please do me the favor of having sex with me.
Okay, stay three steps behind and promise you won't tell anybody.
I promise. I promise.
Tables, Jeff!
Is that a death befitting a Beastmaster?
I never saw Beastmaster. I just wanted to be cool.
I'm coming in there, Pierce.
Buenos dias, Winger.
Sure, you don't want a piece of that.
Surely. What is he doing?
Oh, I know exactly what he's doing. My ex-husband spent 4 weeks doing that after his innocent mistake of calling me Valerie. That boy's living in his car.
How are you gonna get the money?
Believe me, kitten. Winger's got moves.
Jeff, do you need a place to stay?
I'd offer, but my dad's kind of racist.
You can stay with me in the dorms. My room has a bunk bed, which is kind of a misnomer because it's the real deal.
The next person that offers me charity or pity will be mentioned by name in my suicide note.
Oh. No, the less you have, the more you can be. You know what I'm saying?
There's a silver lining here, isn't there? You're attracted to bums.
Good night.
Come on. Why don't you have dinner at my place? I got a hot plate that plugs into a cigarette lighter.
Yeah, but your kitchen's being towed.
Stop! That's my house! Can I live with you?
Yeah, cool. You want the top bunk or the bottom bunk?
Top.
Me too. Race you for it. Boom! Shadowy flight into the world of a man who does not exist. Britta, may I have a word?
Wrong, okay? Material possessions are important. Think how much happier the Jeffersons were than that family on Good Times.
Yeah, but they had good times.
Well, do good times really matter? What about good cars, good lobster? What about that sport where the British people ride the horses with the really long hammers?
Jeez, you are way out of your element here.
Yeah.
And all this work you're doing just to have me around again. You were way more attracted to me than you were willing to admit.
I was doing this all for Abed. You are the worst.
Yeah, clearly. This feels so formal. Let's just talk. People are evil. They can't help it. I didn't catch your name.
It's Jean.
Take Jean here. She spent a lot of time this morning making herself look so lovely. Tell me, Jean, how many people bothered to tell you how great you look today?
None.
Man is evil.
But you just said how great I look.
For my own selfish purposes. The fact is, as hot as you look, and it is quite hot, I wouldn't have said anything. When I talk about people being evil, I could cite quotes or dig up statistics, but those are just words and numbers. I think we could have a little more fun if I express myself in song.
Man is a collection of base animal urges. To act on them and experience sinful pleasure would be morally no different than taking a breath. That's poignant, right?
Yeah.
Abed? Abed?
He was horny, so he dropped him. Man is evil!
Okay, Freud. Sure, you try to penetrate my psychological armor and you and—
Did your wife leave you?
Holy— I like you, Winger.
Pickled bull testicle?
Are you offering or collecting? Jerry Daiquiri.
Jerry Daiquiri.
Later.
You devious clump of overpriced fabric and hair product.
Speaking as one of the meek, as soon as I inherit Earth, you a dead man.
You got a weird forehead.
We're all very disappointed.
All right, dial it back a little, Britta.
I know your secret. I know about the chair.